It's finally here, the next generation of the ASI Air. This one comes with some new features, some requested, some unexpected, but in this video, we're gonna go over my first impressions of the ASI Air Plus, and this video is the first in a short series about the ASI Air Plus, so keep an eye out for the rest of the videos. But hey, if you're new here, my name is Dalen. Here at Astro Escape, we go over all things astrophotography, starting from the very beginner level and working our way up from there, all to help you escape the day-to-day and image the night. If you like what you see as you're watching this video, please do consider giving this one a like. So let's go over a quick unboxing of the ASI Air Plus. When you first open it, you get this nifty little card. It has a bunch of names on it, and it's the ASI Air Dream Partners. Now, I don't think that every name is on this, because if you look at the splash that comes up in the app, it's a similar thing, and the names are a little bit different. So we'll be interested to see if everybody who got the ASI Air Plus early ends up either on these cards or in the app. Of course, opening it up is the ASI Air Plus itself. All right, and with the ASI Air Plus, I mean, it looks pretty much like the old one, but we'll go over that one here in a second. Also in the box that comes with it is a USB 3 Type B cable. So if you ever need to get a replacement cable, it is USB 3 Type B. All right, also in the box is a bag of power cables. You get four of them. Two of them are a meter long, two of them are half a meter long, and all of them are male to male cables. So that means that you plug the cable into the device, just like what you're seeing on screen right now. Okay, and the last two things in the box is the quick start guide and the activation guide. I've already just looked around a little bit in the app, so I've already done the activation part, but really if you just follow the steps on the little card, you'll be fine. And the quick start guide is also good to keep around just so you know which cable or device to plug into which plug, just for the first few times, just so you kind of get used to it if you've never used an ASI Air before. The last thing to note is if you're an ASI Air Pro user or even the previous version, those came with a USB stick and a micro SD card. That doesn't come with the ASI Air Plus, and there's a reason for that we'll get to in a minute. All right, so going over the physical features of the ASI Air Plus, it is a little bit thinner and a little bit lighter than the ASI Air Pro. To me, the case feels like it's a little bit thinner than the Pro. The Pro feels kind of bulky and heavy, but the Plus, it feels a little bit thinner. It almost feels like there's less enclosing heat like this one, even though this one has vents. This one seems like it'll handle heat just a little bit better. But comparing to the Pro, the weights are a little bit different. So the way I did the measurements is both of them with the dovetail attached, because it will be attached to whatever you're attaching it to, and also with and without the antenna for the Plus, just so you can get a feel of how much things weigh. So when it comes to the Plus weighs in at 8.2 ounces or 7.9 without the antenna, or in metric, it is 233 grams or 225 without the antenna. Now switching to the ASI Air Pro, it is 8.4 ounces or it is 239 grams. Now while the weight difference isn't massive, it is a good thing for people that are like really skirting the line of their setup being too heavy for their mount. So we'll see if that quarter of an ounce actually makes a difference in any errors you might be getting in your tracking. All right, on the top of the ASI Air Plus, there's nothing really new. It's the logo. The logo has changed positions a few times, and this one is actually centered around the North Pole region of the sky with constellation lines for the asterisms of the Big and Little Dipper and also the constellation Cassiopeia. And on the Pro, it's pretty similar. However, it's not centered. You just get the asterism stars for the Big and Little Dipper, and that's it. Looking at the rest of it on the bottom, it is just like the same as the Pro. There are spots for your dovetail mount, and there are also four of them, so that way you can rotate it based on however you want to connect it to your mount. And that's nothing new. It's pretty much the same design. All right, starting with the side with the power plugs, there isn't a whole lot that changed. There's still the DSLR shutter cable port if you need to use it, and there's still four power ports. However, the new addition with the ASI Air Plus is that there are now power indicator lights. So if you have to use any one of these ports while you're using them, the light will be on. They don't seem like they'll be that bright out in a dark sky spot. However, if you feel uncomfortable with how bright they are, then you can always put tape over them and just monitor from within the app. The last thing about the power cable side is that there are no slots in it for heat dissipation, just like there were on the Pro. Like I said, the material feels thinner, so it might be able to handle heat better. We're gonna have to find out from somebody who lives in a hotter climate than I do and see if it actually does work better. Moving over to the side with the USB plugs, the Ethernet port is still on the left and the USB plug grouping is still on the right. If you've never used an ASI Air Pro before, there is a difference between using the USB 2 slots, which is the black, and the USB 3 slots, which is the blue. So for example, you want your tracking mount and your auto guider plugged into the USB 2 slots and a extra flash drive and your main camera plugged into the USB 3 slots. Now the reason I mention that is if you are somebody who got used to plugging things in the dark and you just kind of got used to knowing where they are by feel, going, okay, that one's 3, that one's 2, you know, that kind of deal, you have to keep in mind that they swap the positions. USB 2 and 3 have swapped sides. That's one thing to watch out for if you were somebody going off on muscle memory. Okay, let's move over to the other side, the side opposite the power cables. On the Pro, this was primarily just another spot for you to mount your dovetail and another spot for the vents. The spot to mount the dovetail is still there, so that option is still there for you. In fact, it's one that I use almost primarily on the Pro. You can see it here. Beyond mounting the dovetail, this is where a couple of the new features come in. And the first one is the PC slot, where you can plug directly into your computer and transfer the data off of the new internal storage. However, one thing you do need to keep in mind is that you do need to power the plus so the computer will actually detect it and you'll be able to transfer the data off of it. If you don't want to go that route, but you do want to have some extra storage, you also have the micro SD slot, just like what was on the ASI Air Pro. The bonus there is if you use a specific program, you can get up to 1 terabyte of storage to work with as long as it's formatted in FAT32 format. On the last side, this is where the new antenna comes into play, but it's also where you plug in your power supply and you have your power switch. On this, there's also an LED for power and a system indicator, which is green. I wish it was red. Green isn't the worst color they could have gone with, but red would have been the best. The new internal storage is eMMC storage, and that's great because now if you forget your flash drive, then you don't have to worry. You have a way to store your data. It's 32 gigabytes in size, but 12 of that is reserved for the operating system and a recovery partition as well, just in case something happens, it can restore itself. And 20 gigabytes of storage is good, however, they could have gone bigger. Back in the iPhone 7 era of cell phones, 64 gig eMMC storage was the norm. If extra storage is your concern, there is the option for the micro SD card or the flash drive. And the flash drive is actually something I kind of prefer. I stored my ASI Air Pro in the case with the telescope and my Zewo camera, so that way it was all one package. I only had to grab one case. And then at the end of the night, I'd grab the flash drive and stick it in my pocket, and then that would go to my computer. So you have options. If you want to just grab the flash drive and only that goes to your computer with you, that's fine. Or if you want to grab the whole thing and your power supply and ASI and plug that directly into the computer, you have your choice. And moving over to the big new feature, that is the Wi-Fi. So for the ASI Air Pro, the Wi-Fi range was a huge pain point. If you look at my previous videos, you might notice that my mount is set up pretty much right beside my car. It was just far enough away that I wouldn't hit it with the door and I could still have that table there, but close enough that I could sit in my car when it was cold out and stay warm, but also still close enough that it wouldn't disconnect. All right, and the main reasoning for that, it was because of a lack of an external antenna. There was an internal antenna on the ASI Air Pro. However, the case kind of blocked the signal a little bit and it weakened it, and you only had a little bit of range. The Plus comes with an external antenna, and it's also removable. So this creates a whole slew of possibilities for range, but it also allows for simple replacement if something happens to the antenna. Stay tuned up here for the next video, where we're gonna run a few tests and do a comparison between the Plus and the Pro and see what the differences are. Lastly, let's go over a few different changes in the app. So let's go up to the top where the Wi-Fi symbol is, and you'll see the new power monitoring section. And in this power monitoring section, this is where you also toggle on and off all the power ports on the side where you plug them all in. For example, I have it marked here as the top one is my telescope, but that's where I plug in the HEQ5 Pro. Little word of warning, powering your mount through this can be a problem for large mounts. However, for the HEQ5 Pro, I've never really had a problem with it. So if you go ahead and go in, I can just turn this on, and now my HEQ5 Pro, which is sitting at my feet, is currently on. I also have, like I said, my ASI 294 sitting here and plugged in. If I go ahead and turn this on, it's on, however, the fan isn't spinning. But you can see that as we turn these on and off, the power does change just a little bit, and it changes a little bit more like as things are being done. So when you're slewing, the mount will definitely use a little bit more power. Okay, now going over to the camera, if I wanted to turn on cooling, and now it's on. Okay, so the only other new thing in the app is now in the upper right, you have this eMMC icon, and that is where your images will be stored if you're not using a flash drive. So you can go in and look at any plan and just see what it was, or even look at your auto run logs if you want to. If you're like me and still kind of like the convenience of the flash drive and just sticking it in your pocket at the end of the night, you're gonna still wanna plug in the flash drive. And the nifty thing here is if you plug in your flash drive, you will actually get this. And once you get this little pop-up, that means it automatically will save to the flash drive. And going in here, there's actually no clear way I found that says, hey, I actually want it to save mostly to the flash drive, but once it fills up, go to the internal storage. I don't know if that is a thing. I'm actually gonna have to find a smaller flash drive to intentionally fill it up to test that. For now, if you have a flash drive plugged in, it's gonna default to the flash drive, which is kind of nice. Jumping in during editing, I did notice where you can switch between which storage device you want to use. If you look at the top there, there is a little flash icon with the checkbox underneath it. That is how you toggle between your storage devices. And I'm guessing with the SD card, that is where you switch to that as well. However, what I just said about switching to a different device once one is full, that still stands true. I don't know if it automatically does that or not, so I'm still gonna have to test it.
And lastly, looking through all of the other options here, so let's start at the bottom. It's got all your usual stuff about the dream partners. Like I said, I don't know if the names in this list are gonna rotate every now and then, but that's what it is. You have your service agreements, you know, that stuff that people never really ever read. Experimental features, if you have them. But beyond that, all of these don't change. However, there is one menu back in the Wi-Fi settings that I do wanna talk about. The personalized settings option, which was around for the Pro, and it pretty much had the same two options. The sound mode, so that beep that happens when you turn it on, you can change that, and also change your temperature unit. There is one thing missing from personalized that they really need to add, and that is red mode. I can't believe they still haven't done this. This is an astronomy app. And look, I get that the idea of the ASI Air is to be able to get it set up in the backyard, get it running, and then come inside and stay safe from the bugs during the summer and the cold during the winter, but that's simply not the case for every customer of the ASI Air. The simple fact of the matter is that not every customer of ASI Air has a backyard to work with. Of those people, quite a few of them have to travel to an observatory or some other dark sky spot, and are usually somewhere where there are some restrictions to the lighting to keep things dark for others observing. And while the colors of the app aren't that bright, even at the dimmest settings on this tablet and the iPad and my cell phone, it still can be seen from a little bit away. Most devices do have a way to cover your whole device in a red film, and I gotta say Apple's doing a better job than Android, because Apple does a deep red and Android not so much, but it's still not the best. And the reasoning for that is using those color lenses or color filters, I believe, are the two different names. What happens is certain colors in the app get really hard to see, and even if you're using a piece of red cellophane over your device, those colors are a little bit hard to see. So there just needs to be a red mode that can be used in areas where the lighting of the area is pretty strict. And having a red mode that is purely designed to show all elements of the user interface would be just completely fantastic. So Zewell, I hope you heard this one, and please bring in a red mode. All in all, it's a fairly solid device. A quick glance in the app means people switching over from previous versions won't be confused, because it's pretty much laid out the same, and the same physically can be said about the device itself. And anyone coming over from the Pro to the Plus, it'll make things go a little bit smoother. If you found this video helpful, please do like, comment, and then maybe consider subscribing. I want to thank you for watching. Clear skies.